Today in the news, we have Zen 2, Vega 20, and a movie in 2022. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. AMD's Next Horizon event showed us some pretty interesting data center products. They announced the launch of their latest chip design, and they showed us the first 7-nanometer server CPU based on the Zen 2 architecture. Zen 2 brings in tremendous performance per watt increase to this Rome iteration of the Epic line of CPUs. According to AMD, you can get 25% more performance at the same power consumption, or you can get half the power consumption at the same level of performance of their last generation Epic. With Threadripper 2 going up to 32 cores, it's not surprising that this Epic CPU core count goes all the way up to 64 cores and 128 threads. Now let's talk about the most surprising part of the new architecture. Zen 2 marks a departure from the way Zen and Zen Plus were designed. Instead of having multiple dies on the same process that contained things like the core complex, the I/O, the memory controllers, etc., Zen 2 opts for a main I/O die in the middle of the chip containing everything but the core complexes. They then use the second generation of Infinity Fabric to make the connection between the main I/O die and what they call chiplets. Chiplets are essentially what the old core complexes were. What I find really clever here is the use of 14-nanometer lithography on the main I/O die. Technically, that also means that Zen 2 is not 100% 7-nanometers. With their Zen Plus CPUs up and running, it's also a little surprising that the I/O / Infinity Fabric die isn't made on the 12-nanometer process. Anyways, this chiplet design will probably make the yields better on that process since the lithography will be less complex. Not only that, but if we try to transpose Zen 2 to the third generation of Ryzen CPUs, there is a high chance that we will see a higher core count. I highly doubt that AMD would fit an I/O die this big, or even half the size, without at least two chiplets of 8 cores each on it. Remember, these chiplets don't contain I/O, so AMD can't really divide them like they did on Zen and Zen Plus. Here are my prediction for Ryzen's third generation. We'll see a main I/O chip with two chiplets of 8 cores each. On Ryzen 3, we'll have 8, 10, and 12 cores enabled, and on Ryzen's fourth generation, we might see them all enabled for a 16-core variant. What am I basing this on? Well, it's pretty much what they did with Threadripper 1 and 2. I could talk about Zen 2 for hours, but I'll stop here because we need to move on. Looks like we're not moving too far off AMD because they announced their Radeon Instinct line. The MI60 and MI50 accelerators feature the 7-nanometer Vega 20 architecture and are made on the 7-nanometer process. I'm less interested in these because we don't have much to extrapolate their performance from. One thing I am interested in is the Infinity Fabric links. This tech allows up to 8 GPUs to work together to deliver massive computational power. I know that Kaduri wanted to implement the Infinity Fabric deeper into the Vega line of GPUs, but I highly doubt that this is the way he envisioned it. I mean, I was expecting something similar to Zen 2 with an I/O die and graphics chiplets that would be seen by the OS as one GPU, basically like a crossfire without crossfire. Then we have Samsung. Today is the day of their developer conference, although this video will be released before the event. Apparently, one of the things that Samsung will talk about is opening Bixby to third-party developers. This would allow it to be used in a similar fashion to Alexa or Google Home. I personally love this idea, but I wouldn't really use it since I'm already deep into the Amazon ecosystem. I'm currently in the process of wiring all of my home lighting so it works with Alexa with those little Sonoff RF/Wi-Fi controllers. It's super cheap and works pretty well in my experience. And lastly, do you remember the Super Mario Brother movie?
Trust the fungus.
Yeah, well, apparently a new Super Mario Brother movie is expected to be released. Don't worry though, this one will be an animated one. Chris Meledandri, producer of Despicable Me, hopes to launch the film in 2022 with the assistance of Mario creator Shigeru Miyamoto. Mario has a rocky past in terms of film adaptation, but if someone can do a good job of it, it's probably these two. Alright, so that is pretty much it for the news, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop me a like where it counts. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. I'm gonna try something different here for the outro. Okay? Let me know if you... Alright, take care, guys. I didn't say it.